Okay, working as an associate professor in electronics department at Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this video lecture, we are going to discuss on a microwave solid state device, that is GUNN diode. Learning outcomes. After completion of this session, students are able to describe construction, working and characteristics of the GUNN diode. They are also able to know the application area. These are the contents which we'll be discussing in this video lecture. Basically, a GUNN diode is a semiconductor device which is formed by only N type of material. Like other type of semiconductor devices, there is a P type and N type of, and they form a junction. That's why they form a diode. But it consists of only N type of material, but it consists of a 2 electrode. As the devices has a lower energy level and higher energy layer, the electrons from the lower energy levels are being transferred into the higher energy level. That's why these devices are called as a transverse electron devices. These diodes are also called as a negative resistance devices, due to which they are used to generate a microwave frequency at a low power, or they may use as a low power oscillator to generate the microwave frequencies. Now, what is a negative resistance devices? Negative resistance devices allows the current in one direction at which its resistance is very low, that is almost equal to zero during its forward bias. While even if it is consist of one type of material, it gives the zero resistance. Similarly, in a other direction, it does not allow the current to flow, as it offers a high resistance during its reverse bias. This negative resistance characteristics is being observed in a devices. Now let us see the internal structure and symbol of the GUNN diode. This is a symbol of the GUNN diode, which is having the 2 electrode, anode and cathode. If you see the internal structure of the GUNN diode, it is fabricated by the 3 layers, in which the middle layer is lightly doped compared with the other 2 layers. The middle layer is called as a active layer. This entire layer is fabricated on a conducting material which acts as a heat sink and which also contribute as electrode cathode. If you observe here, there is a gold wire or a gold alloy conducting material which is fabricated on the top surface, which contribute the anode for the device. Working of the GUNN diode. As we have previously said that it consists of only N type of semiconductor material, in which electrons are a majority carriers. These electrons forms a current, generate the current, and this device utilize the GUNN effect. Now what is the GUNN effect? Let us discuss in the next slide. This diode is made up of a single piece of N type of semiconductor material, such as gallium arsenide or indium phosphate. As the gallium arsenide or indium phosphate have a high mobility electron, that's why they are used in constructing of the GUNN diode. The gallium arsenide has a one extra energy band bands in their electron band structure, instead of having only 2 energy band, that is a valence band and the conduction band. Now, what is a GUNN effect? It is a phenomena that occurs when the external voltage is applied to the GUNN diode. When an external voltage is applied, the electrons from the lower energy band are passed into the higher electron, higher energy band. As it has a electrons has a mass, the electrons moves from the lower energy band to the higher energy band. When the external applied voltage exit, the electrons from the higher energy band form a cluster of the electron. This forms this cluster of electrons moves with the constant rate, and these movements create a current in a device. This effect is called as a Gunn effect. Now let us discuss the working with using this energy band diagram. In a gallium arsenide device, it consists of is represented by three energy band, that is valence band, conduction band, high energy band. Now as the external applied voltage is increased, the electrons from the valence band moves into the conduction band. Further increasing in the voltage, external voltage, the electrons from the conduction band moves into the higher energy band. That's why they are called as a transverse electron devices. Now once they move into the higher energy band, the mass increases. As their mass increases, this reduces in the movability of this device decreases. As the mass increases, movability decreases. Due to the movability decrease and increase in the mass, and as we further increase the voltage, the electrons from the conduction band start moving, coming back into the from the higher band start coming back into the conduction band. Due to this, there is a decrease in the current. If you observe the VI characteristics of the Gunn diode, initially this diode, when there is a increase in, as the voltage increases, the current also increases. If we can see in this diagram, the as the voltage is increasing, current is also increasing linearly till the peak point. The old current increases. After that peak voltage, the current start decreasing, and this will form a negative resistance in the device. As the current start decreasing, it decreases till the particular voltage, which is called as a value point voltage. After the value point voltage, again the current start increasing. In this way, there are the current fluctuations in the device. That's why this creates the oscillations in the device. That's why these devices can be used as an oscillator for generating the frequencies at a microwave range, that is in a high frequency range. Now let us see the applications where the Gunn diodes are being used. As this Gunn diode previously discussed, they are used as a Gunn oscillator to generate the frequency which are ranging from 5 gigahertz to 35 gigahertz, and with the low power, that is 100 milliwatts to 1 watt. Due to this, they are used at a radio communication, military, and a commercial radar sources. They are used for the remote vibrating detector and the rotational speed measuring tachometer. The Gunn diode are used as a pulse Gunn diodes, which are used for generating the microwave current. They are used in a microwave transmitters to generate a radio waves at very low power. They are also used as a fast controlling component in a microelectronics, such as the modulations of the semiconductor injection laser. And they are also used as a sub millimeters wave applications by multiplying the Gunn oscillator frequency with the diode frequencies. These are the few applications areas due to which they are being used. Also, they are used in a practical applications because as they are working with the low power in an academic. These are the few references through which a data is being collected.